I pity the fool that ain't got no crypto.
If you're not holding crypto and you're not accepting it as a graphic designer, a web designer, an emotion designer, you're seriously missing out. I accept crypto. I don't even market that I accept crypto, but to the right clients and the right people, I accept it. And it's actually something I'm going to start publicly putting out there in 2021, that we accept crypto. We're going to talk about why you should accept crypto as a designer and how you can leverage it to help you grow your income and make it a smart investment for you. There are some risks and we're going to talk about that, but without further ado, let's go ahead and just jump right into it. Hey, welcome back to another Adrian Graphics and Marketing video. I am Adrian Boysel, CEO and founder of the company, and I'm making these videos to help you guys grow your income, help you guys become three-dimensional business owners in your health, in your wealth, and in your relationships. If you're just now coming to the channel, make sure you hit a like button, hit that subscribe button so you get notified of all my awesome videos that I make to help designers around the world become three-dimensional. So today we're gonna talk about cryptocurrency and why I think it's a great opportunity and why you should be taking it as a designer. Now, let me give you a little bit of backstory. I actually started taking crypto and accepting crypto from people within my company that were working for me as payment for lunch. I had a really early adopter, a friend of mine who told me about cryptocurrency. And one day out of nowhere, he's like, "Do you have a Coinbase account?" And I said, "No, what the heck is that?" And he started explaining what cryptocurrency was, how there was millions of computers out there, how it was much harder to basically have fraud and how it separated these ledgers across millions of computers. So if somebody was gonna hack it, they had to be able to hack a million plus computers, probably more than that, probably hundreds of millions of computers all at once at the exact same time from one place. And that's basically impossible. I'm sure there are people that have been able to manipulate things and have been able to steal access to people's wallets, but cryptocurrency is a very safe, decentralized, and that is the key word here, decentralized currency. They call it DeFi, decentralized finance. And so if you're not accepting it, you're really missing out on a huge wave and a huge buzz. I'm sure you've heard of Bitcoin. You've probably even heard of Ethereum. These are two of the biggest and most popular mainstream coins. And then there's also altcoins like XRP and Litecoin and Dogecoin. You don't want to accept all those, but I want to talk about some of those things and what the benefits are for you accepting that as a graphic designer. All right. Now, number one, like I said, it's a decentralized blockchain and it's much harder to hack. It's harder to get access to your wallet, especially if you use two-factor authentication, and especially if you get something like a Nano S and back up all your crypto onto cold storage. You have these passwords to be able to get into the drive. It makes it very, very secure, and you keep those things in your safe, in your safety deposit box, wherever you want, and it's gonna keep your cryptocurrency safe from anybody being able to take it. And I really love that about cryptocurrency. It is a safe platform, and it gives you more privacy. So number two, and this is a really important one, is there are very low fees to send and receive cryptocurrency. The fees are very, very nominal. Some of the apps like Coinbase are on the more expensive side for fees, but there's other ones like Binance and BitPay and BitMEX and some other platforms out there that you can use, including Gemini. But I personally recommend Coinbase and Binance. Those are the two ones that I rely on. Those are the ones that I use. If you heard of Gemini, it's probably because the Winklevoss twins own Gemini. That is their platform. And it's made for more institutions and what they call whales. But these Coinbase type of accounts where you're gonna have is your wallet. This is where you're gonna buy and send and receive your cryptocurrency. And so you need to set one of those accounts up to be able to get payments, send payments, and you can actually buy things like cars and all kinds of stuff. They even have Bitcoin ATM machines. Now, I was in a store the other day and I walked into, it was a Power Mart, and I walked in and they had a Bitcoin ATM machine. It absolutely blew my mind. So the other thing that I really love, and this is number three, is chargebacks. For all of you business owners that are designers that have dealt with nightmare clients that have done chargebacks on you, this goes away. Nobody can do a chargeback on the cryptocurrency blockchain platform. And I love that. That is awesome. And not that I get a bunch of chargebacks, but it's just that next level of security to make sure that you're not getting screwed over by people, by customers that you're working really hard for and them just taking advantage. I was talking about that today with somebody, of doing a bunch of work and then having somebody do a chargeback on you and you having little to no fight in that game. And so I want to be able to help more people move over to blockchain and start utilizing blockchain, because the number four thing is that it reduces fraud. And this is very, very important. If you want to be able to increase your value and protect your money and protect your business from all kinds of fraud, blockchain can help you do that. I think there's all different types of use cases for blockchain that's being developed, from logistics to digital gold like Bitcoin is, and banking like XRP and Ethereum. There's all kinds of people with different use cases, and that's what makes a blockchain and a cryptocurrency itself valuable, is what is the use of it. You really need to understand that. Okay, and then the number five thing that I think is really important for you to understand is cryptocurrency, although it's volatile and has ups and downs over the long span of time, and you can see it right now. When I started doing this back in 2017 and getting paid for lunch from my guy that was working for me, that cryptocurrency made me thousands of dollars. It was probably $60, $70 worth of Bitcoin. And when that thing rose up to $11,000 at the peak of that time, I made thousands of dollars off of that. And that's what made me a true believer in Bitcoin and some of these altcoins, as I saw that the long-term picture, the long game, the hodl gang, hold on for dear life. The longer you hold on to it, the more value those cryptocurrencies become. So it's really important that you understand that, that you know that you gotta be in there for the long term. Now, number six, you have to be able to go in with some parameters, with some boundaries, with some expectations. You need to set a max amount of cryptocurrency that you're going to accept as a business on a monthly basis. You can't just take 100% of the work that you do all in crypto. You could if you want to, if you have other income streams coming in. But the other thing that you could do is you could cash out half of it and keep the other half in your account. There's a lot of people that do that. What I believe is it's always good to have boundaries, because there is always risk within cryptocurrency and other things like that. Is you just want to make sure that you have other revenue streams and you decentralize the way that you accept money. You don't want to only rely on cryptocurrency, and not everybody's going to be able to pay you in that, but just set a threshold, whether that's $5,000 a month, $10,000 a month. I think this is really important for people to understand, and I hope many of you guys are already doing this that are already trading in crypto. Number seven, and this is a very big deal, is cryptocurrency is still new. It hasn't been massively adopted yet. It still kind of belongs to the early adopters and the mid adopters. There's some mid adopters now that are starting to jump on the bandwagon and jump into Bitcoin because they're hearing about it. The news is explosive. Bitcoin has basically become a household name, but not everybody owns it. It's about 40% of our generation, the millennials and younger, already own Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. And 40 to 50%, I think that they're gonna own it over the next 5 years. So as the next 5 years goes and passes, we're gonna see the price of Bitcoin go from what it is now, which I think is right around $32,000, and as high as $500. And that's speculative. I'm not here to give financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor in any way, but I believe that the potential for Bitcoin could go up to $500,000 in the next 5 years because of how many people are using it, because of more people adopting it, and it being the gold of crypto and the blockchain. I believe that it can increase in value, and there's only a certain number of coins available on the marketplace. And tip number eight, and the reason why I think you should buy cryptocurrency or accept cryptocurrency, is because it opens you up to those early adopters and those mid adopters, the people who are ahead of the curve, who adopt technology quickly, people who are like Apple, people who are willing to stand in line for the brand new iPhone or the newest piece of technology. Those kinds of people are innovative, they're forward thinking, and they understand the value of cryptocurrency, and they're gonna see you as cutting edge and advanced as well. So it's gonna add some credibility to you, and it's gonna give you more options to accept money. And to be honest, there's a ton of people out there like me that are sitting on quite a bit of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and XRP, and sitting on a lot of cryptocurrency, and it's making them money, and they can take some of that principal, take some of that profit, and make investments into marketing, into design, into branding, into graphics, into pay-per-click. They can make some of those investments with this money that they're sitting on and turn that even into more money. So it's a great opportunity to bring in more clients, to show that you're cutting edge and add some more credibility to you. Now, the big thing that you're probably wondering is, how do I get started in crypto? And I talked a little bit about that at the beginning of, you can set up a Coinbase account or a Binance account. All you gotta do is go through that. You can download the app on your phone. I'm sure you can do it from a browser, and you set up your account. It's gonna ask you for some basic information. I think it might ask you for your social, because there's some tax parameters and some things that you need to talk to your tax guy about to make sure that you're falling in line with those parameters. But it's really easy to set up a Coinbase account. Coinbase is as popular as it is because it's really easy to use. and they have a ton of coins on there. They did recently remove XRP, which I think was a bad move. It was really dumb because XRP has a court case right now, but that is just gonna bring a lot of regulatory clarity to the industry, which the industry is desperately needing right now. So I know that this is gonna blow over and then the XRP token will most likely skyrocket like it's never skyrocketed before, and the whole industry is going to skyrocket because of this. The second thing you need to know as you start to set this up and you get started is you never share your wallet address or your credentials with anybody that you don't personally know and trust. If you can't see them face to face, if you don't have their information, if you don't really know that person, you do not share that information. A lot of people are getting their wallets hacked, and that's why it's really important for you to secure your accounts with a 2FA, two-factor authentication. And you can even use an authenticator app where you actually have to log onto your phone, open the app and get a code and put that in to be able to log in. So it's not even a text message that can be spoofed or hacked or anything like that. It makes it much, much more secure. Never share your credentials with somebody you don't know. Be careful of spoofing emails of saying that your Coinbase account has been hacked. There's all kinds of ways that people are trying to hack and steal cryptocurrency. And so you need to be very aware of that. This is a new technology. With new technologies come new challenges and new security things. And because it's decentralized, it's almost impossible to track down that person that jacked you. So it's important to make sure that you protect yourself and you have good security when you get started. Number three, and I talked about this a little bit, is you need to make sure that you cash out some of the profits from that. If you do a logo for somebody and you charge them $1,000 and they pay you all in crypto, take a couple hundred bucks of that out. Take 250 of it out and cash it out into a fiat currency. If you don't know what a fiat currency is, that is hard dollar bills. Man, I wish I had some actual dollar bills on me here to make the sound. But you can actually cash that out into real currency, into fiat currency. And so knowing that you can actually do that gives you even more incentive to accept it because you can immediately cash it out. And that's one of the things I love about cryptocurrency is it's available immediately. That wasn't one of my bullet points, but it's a really good bullet point that I should have added, is you can cash out your cryptocurrency right now. It's instant gratification, where a lot of things that you're trying to cash out, if you accept credit cards, takes a day to 2 days and sometimes 3 days to actually get paid out. So this is something really important that you should know about cryptocurrency, is it's instantly available. And that's why I see it being so big. It's gonna be in every asset of our life, from music to web browsers and all that. So cryptocurrency is gonna be massive, and it's something that you really should get started with. Now, the last thing you should know and you should be thinking about as you get started accepting cryptocurrency is what currencies you want to accept. I would personally recommend you follow the biggest ones first, the top three or four, and those ones are Bitcoin, regular BTC. There's Bitcoin Gold, which is good. You have Ethereum, which is really, really great. And then you have Ethereum Classic, you have XRP, and there's even ones out there like VET. I'm gonna throw VET in there because I think that it has great potential. I've done a lot of research on it. But make sure that you're aware of which ones you want to accept and which ones you don't accept, because some of these are very, very volatile and some of them don't have good use cases. Like Dogecoin just started because of an internet meme and was a total joke. There isn't a really good use case behind that. But other coins like Bitcoin, Bitcoin Gold, Ethereum, XRP, they have very, very good use cases, and I don't think they're going anywhere. I only see them increasing in value. So make sure that you're aware of which ones you accept and which ones you don't, and then you can go out and promote that you accept those coins. I'm personally accepting two, which is Bitcoin, Ethereum. I'm not doing XRP at the moment just because of some of the stuff that's going on. It's not that I don't believe in it, but I just want to stick with the big two because I know that those are the ones that most people are using. So that's my advice for you guys. I really think, and I want to encourage you guys to start using cryptocurrency. I'm sitting on a nice stash of crypto that's on cold storage that no one will ever find, trust me. And it's really important that you start thinking innovatively and opening yourself to new clients. So that's what I got for you guys today. I hope that was interesting. I hope that was fun. It's a little bit different take than I normally do, talking about how to grow your design business. But I think this is an important topic to start getting paid and start receiving money from people who are sitting on fat stashes of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. I know I'm gonna be paying for more things, and eventually my crypto wallet will probably be my bank account. I may not even need my bank account anymore. So I think things are gonna really advance in this space, and I want you to start jumping on that train too. So I love you guys. I thank you for watching this video. I hope it helped, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the next one. I'm Adrian Boysel, and as always, keep looking up.